Tudor was the most hated queen in British history. During her five-year reign, she threw all England into chaos. Mary beheaded traitors, murdered heretics, and had pregnant women burnt to death in the name of her religious fanaticism. The entire nation lived in fear of her.
Make no mistake about it, the burning of somebody at the stake is a very nasty business. It takes a long time to die. The smell of human burning fat would have been overpowering.
There were nearly 300 burnt in about 3.5 years in Mary's reign, which was actually more than the Spanish Inquisition and the French Chambre Ardente put together in the same period.
Thousands fled into hiding, and the streets of English cities were polluted with the putrid smell of burning flesh. She created such terror that she's known as Bloody Mary. Mary Tudor was born at Greenwich in 1516. She was the only surviving child of King Henry VIII and his first wife, Catherine of Aragon.
The reaction to Mary's birth is one of happiness, but very muted happiness, really. People were not cheered up by the fact that the child that was born and lived was a daughter.
Henry wanted a son to succeed him, and Mary's arrival was seen as a second-rate birth. After several miscarriages and 5 dead children, Mary's mother, Catherine of Aragon, went through the menopause. Henry knew that she could never provide him with the male heir he so desperately wanted.
Henry realized that there would be no son and began asking, well, why? And his answer was, well, God doesn't want me to have a son because my marriage is wrong. My marriage doesn't exist.
England was a Catholic country, but the Pope would not allow Henry to annul his marriage. Henry broke from Rome and declared himself the supreme head of the new Church of England. In January 1533, after learning that one of his courtiers, Anne Boleyn, was pregnant, Henry secretly married her to avoid the risk of having a bastard son. But Anne gave birth to a girl, Mary's stepsister Elizabeth. 4 months later, his Archbishop of Canterbury, Thomas Cranmer, declared Henry's marriage to Catherine null and absolutely void, and pronounced his marriage to Anne good and lawful. Mary was 17 years old.
Therefore, Mary was illegitimate. Suddenly, this child who's been treated like the most special girl around is told that she has to say, from now on, she is a bastard.
Like her mother, Mary refused to accept this decree. The bond between mother and daughter became stronger. They were totally dedicated to the traditional form of Catholicism that Henry had abolished.
Right at the center of Mary's life was a drama. It's called the Mass. It's a drama of light and color and Latin and music, and at the heart of it you make God on a table out of bread and wine. And for Mary, that was absolutely central.
When Catherine's health began to deteriorate, Mary was banished from her room. Catherine died in 1536 without ever seeing her daughter again. Mary finally signed her father's act of succession in the same year, but she didn't hide her hatred of Anne Boleyn.
I think Mary is pushed aside by Anne Boleyn, there's no doubt about that. She would have regarded, as her mother regarded Anne Boleyn, as what the Spanish ambassador always calls Anne Boleyn, which is the whore.